So we're on our celebration journey right now, folks. We're celebrating. We just left all these holidays. We left kind of a holiday. It's called Halloween. But literally, it's Halloween. It's the time when we remember death. That's what it's all about, is death. Kind of memorialize death, because death becomes our friend eventually. It's our enemy now, but at one point it becomes our friend and actually takes us into eternal life through Christ Jesus. We have to die in order to enter into His glory. And then from now we went to Thanksgiving, and Thanksgiving is the time when we say it's going to show to God and to everybody around us that we love and are part of our life. We thank God for the gospel message He gave us and the eternal life that He's given to each of us who named Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. And now we go to Christmas, the Mass of Christ, where we celebrate His birth, where Christ comes in the Incarnation, Emmanuel, God with us. He comes to dwell in the tents of humanity. He comes to dwell with us. He says He tabernacles with us. He comes down as a child, God in human flesh, fully God, fully man, the great incarnational step into humanity's life to take humanity out of death and give us eternal life like Him and strengthen us in our life towards Him, take away our sin and our degradation. And that's what this time is all about. You know, it's interesting. It all connects to housing, too, and homelessness. Because God comes when He comes as a child. How does He come to us? In swaddling clothes, prepared for His, already prepared for His death. And He said He's born in a cave where they have the animals. The cave is representative of the very tomb that He will enter into us for us later in this 33 years of ministry when He goes to the cross. So it's amazing. All this all comes together with all this beautiful message. And the message is here, the God of humanity who loves us all comes as a child in human form and He's left outside. No place to lay His head, it says. That stinks. Think about it. He had no roof. But the shepherd, they took Him in. The innkeeper took Him in. And He's in there and He sat in His manger. And He became the food for humanity. You know, manger means manja. That means to eat. Manja, manja. That's what the animals eat, the straw from the hay from. I mean the hay, not the straw. They eat the hay from there and the grain. It's put in the manger. Here's the food of the world. Christ Jesus comes down, God in human flesh, become the bread of life, become the fountain of immortality, for the water that would flow eternally into us and nourishing our souls. He laid there in this barn, inside this big rock. That's all the world had, that's all the earth had to offer, and even the creation had took to its king and said, stick him in the corner. And then, what's God do then for us? He then takes us to glory with Himself. And He says, I'm going to prepare a place for you. In my Father's house there are many dwellings. He's going to take us from here, from this homeless condition, right on up with Him in heaven. And we'll be in His dwellings. This is all relates to what we do, keeping people housed, keeping people nourished. That's what worship is. That's what caring is about in the gospel message. God cared for us. He loved us so much that He gave His only begotten Son for us. He gives us. We should be caring and giving to each other at least as much as Christ gave to us as a child. Even more so if you claim Christ is in your heart. There's no one that should be outdoors in your neighborhood. No one should be homeless in your neighborhood. No child, no single, no man, no woman, no grandma, no grandpa. Everybody should have a roof. Everybody should have a place. Because we care about them. We love them. Nobody should be outside in the cold. So just remember, you see a person standing out there, what did Jesus say? If you receive me, to them, you receive me also. If you've done it to them, you've done it to me also. Why? Because in that little manger scene in Christmas, this innkeeper said, come on in. No room in the inn, but I can take you out to the barn and give you the cave. That's what homelessness is meant to infuse in us, help us waken us to see God in the midst of all of our life. Even in Christ's homelessness when He came, He said even in His life He had no place to rest His head, to lay His head. No place. So, only the places that people invited Him into. And you need to invite Him into your heart. That's the real home for Christ. If you leave Him outside just knocking, that's a bad scene for you. So remember that. He's knocking at your door. And so are the homeless knocking at your door outside there. Christ, that homeless guy, said, let me in, let me in. You better open your hearts to Him too, and the mothers and children out there. Open your hearts to receive God in and through those people who are created in His image. Jesus says, if you've done it to the least of these, you've done it unto me. Do the same. Reach out to them, just like Jesus reached out to us. Come from heaven. Step down from your lofty place and give opportunities to people in their lives. Give them opportunities. Open your heart, open your mind, open your love to each of the people that are struggling in life. Have a good day. A little many words. I hope they're clear. If they're not clear, write me, I'll clarify them for you. May the Lord bless you. May he keep you. May he bless you in all the things that you do and say. Honor Jesus Christ. Glory to Jesus Christ. Glory forever. Amen.